I am sincerely sorry. Over a month ago at this point, I reacted to the first two songs off Folklore, The One and Cardigan. And in that video, I literally said I was going to upload every like other day or whatever, reacting to the rest of the album. And, you know, I got really lazy and I was slacking off. I did other reactions and everything, and I haven't gotten around to listening to the rest of the album. So I'm going to make a really long video today. I'm setting aside, I don't know how long, this is a long album. I have, I think, 16 songs left. It's an 18 song album. So I'm going to sit and listen through 16 songs straight in one video. This is about to be a long video. I'm going to put timestamps down in the comments, or like the first comment. I'll probably pin it, okay? Or should I put it in the description? I don't know. But I'm going to put timestamps. And yeah. Anyway, thank you guys for tuning in. We're about to get into this, but you guys know. I don't know. Do you know? We're more than just reactions. I want you to hit that subscribe button. Become a part of this journey. And yeah, Taylor Swift, Folklore. It's already going to be a really long video. Definitely going to be over an hour. So I'm just going to start this. I'm going to have to change out the battery multiple times because the battery life on this camera is kind of trash. Very trash. But so we're going to get right into this. The Last Great American Dynasty. Official lyric video. All right, let's get this started. Come on, Taylor. Show me what you got, dog. I really like that font. I don't know why.
Rebecca rode up on the afternoon train. It was sunny. Her salt box house on the coast took her mind off St. Louis. Bill was the heir to the Standard Oil name.
This is really beautiful. Money. Cool scenery.
And the town said, how did a middle class divorce they do it?
Facts though.
The wedding was charming, if a little gauche. There's only so far new money goes. They picked out a home and called it Holiday House.
Oh, also, sorry, I'm pausing it so early, but you guys know. The title says Hater Reacts. If you didn't watch the first reaction to the first two songs, you know, that's complete clickbait. I'm not a Taylor Swift hater, but I'm not a fan, you know? And yeah, I think, you know, I respect her. I respect all the work and how she stayed on top for so long. I respect all that. You know, I'm just not like a really big fan or anything like that. So yeah, you're getting clickbaited for sure. But yeah, I'm not like out here trying to hate on her. So like chill. I've seen some comments being like, yo, you're a hater. If you hate her music, you're like anti-women or something like that. Someone said that in the comments. I'm like, bro, what? Literally, if you watch the first video, I was actually complimenting the song Cardigan. I literally said it was a good song. Anyway, whatever, dude. Hate is gonna hate. You feel me? That's what they think I am.
Their parties were tasteful, if a little loud. The doctor had told him to settle down. It must have been her fault his heart gave out. And they said, there goes the last great American dynasty. Who knows if she never showed up, what could have been. There goes the maddest woman this town has ever seen. She had a marvelous time ruining everything. Rebecca gave up on the Rhode Island set forever. Flew in all her bitch pack friends from
whoa,
the city.
Whoa, Taylor. It's so weird hearing her
curse. Champagne and swam with the big names and blew through the money on the boys and the ballet. And losing on card game bets with Dolly. Said, there goes the last great American dynasty.
I like how it's building on itself.
Who knows if she never showed up, what could have been. There goes the most shameless woman this town has ever seen.
I wish the harmony was a little bit louder.
She had a marvelous time ruining everything.
Oh my god. Let's see if the harmony comes in loud for this score. Who knows if I never showed up, what could have been? There goes the loudest woman this town has ever seen. Yeah, it's a little louder. I had a marvelous time ruining everything. I had a marvelous time ruining everything. A marvelous time ruining everything. A marvelous time. I had a marvelous time. All right. So I think that's written by Taylor Swift and Aaron Dresser. But okay. Yeah, I think I like the first two songs more from what I can remember. The song was okay. It's not definitely not a bad song. It's pretty chill. But there really wasn't much to it. Like I said, guys, you might dislike the video just because of that, but you know, it's just my opinion. I don't think that was the best song. But I don't think it was a bad song by any means. So we're gonna go to Exile featuring Bon Iver. However, Bon Iver. Gonna go right into it. Dude, I love the scenery, man.
I can see you standing, honey, with his arms around your body, laughing but
super the joke's low voice.
Not funny at all. And it took you 5 whole minutes.
I like that melody a lot, a lot. That's my type of melody right there.
All this love out here in the hall.
I once wrote a melody like that, but the cameras are off.
I think I've seen this film before, and I didn't like the ending. You're not my
home. I like the harmony right there.
So what am I defending now? You were my town. Now I'm in exile, seeing you out. I think I've seen this film before.
I can see you staring, honey, like he's just your understudy. Like you'd get your knuckles bloody for me. Second, third, and hundredth chances, balancing on breaking bridges. Those eyes add insult to injury. I think I've seen this film before, and I didn't like the end.
I really like the melody, not gonna lie.
Seen this film before, so I'm leaving out the side door.
So step right out. There is no amount of cry I can do for all this time. We always want a very thin line. You didn't even hear me out.
Didn't even hear me
out. You never gave a warning sign.
The mixing is so nice here. Harmony.
Beautiful. I think I've seen this film before, and I didn't like the ending. You're not my homeland anymore.
Yeah.
So what am I defending now? You were my town.
and step right out.
Justin Vernon. Yeah, Justin Vernon. Is he like the main singer in Bon Iver? I don't know. I like that song a lot, actually. I really like the melody line, as you guys can tell. And I like the dual story, like the two sides of the story. Is like, you know, this guy was just unaware of all the crap that he was doing to the girl. And, you know, and I don't know. It's I always like when you have like two sides to the story. So now we're gonna go into My Tears Ricochet. My friend was telling me this is her favorite song off the album. So Isabel, if you're watching this, don't let me down. Don't let me down, okay? Probably gonna let me down, honestly. Sorry, I'm talking for this intro. Whatever. My video, haha. Really pretty.
We gather here, we line up, we've been in a sunlit room. And
if that sound
I'm
a little weird.
On fire, you'll be made of ashes too. Even on my worst day, did I deserve, babe, all the hell you gave me?
Nah, dog.
Cause I loved you, I swear I loved you, till my dying day. I didn't have it in myself to go with grace. And you're the hero flying around saving face. And if I'm dead to you, why are you at the wake? Cursing my name, wishing I stayed. Look at how my tears ricochet.
It's written really, really well. Written very well. Very sad.
We gather stones, never knowing what they'll mean. Some to throw, some to make a diamond ring. You know I didn't want to have to haunt you, but what a ghostly scene. You wear the same jewels that I gave you as you bury me. I didn't have it in myself to go with grace. Cause when I'd fight, you used to tell me I was brave. And if I'm dead to you, why are you at the way?
Keep building, keep building. The way she sings that kind of reminds me of Miley Cyrus.
And so the battleships will sink beneath the waves. You had to kill.
name. Wishing I Stayed. Just indecisiveness right there. Straight up indecisiveness. All of her songs are, you know, they're really well written. I don't think you could listen to a Taylor Swift song and be like, yeah, those lyrics are terrible. Like, she's always gonna produce really good lyrics. So we're gonna move on to Mirror. But oh, also Isabel, maybe that's a song that, you know, you have to like listen to a few times for you to like really, really, really start getting into it. But off the first listen, I wouldn't say that's my favorite song off the album so far. But Mirrorball, Taylor Swift, hopping right into it. You already know. And also, I wanted to say this album's kind of sad. Like, just a really sad vibe to like all the songs, which is okay. I really, you know, people actually make fun of me. Like, my friends make fun of me and say like I only listen to sad music, which, you know, they're not wrong. I mean, they are wrong, because like to me, it's like the music doesn't sound sad. It's just like, I guess like the sad chords, and sad-ish melodies really resonate with me, and I feel it a lot more. And yeah, so I dig this. The whole sad vibe. Taylor getting in her feels. I like that. I love the guitar. I'll show you every version of yourself. Super chill. Tonight. I'll get you out on the floor. Shimmering beautiful. And when I break it in a million pieces. Hush, when no one is around, my dear. You'll find me on my tallest tiptoes. Spinning in my highest heels, love shining just for you. Hush, I know they said the end is near, but I'm still on my tallest tiptoes. Spinning in my highest heels, love shining just for you. I would have loved to go there. That would have hit me. Drunk as they watch my shattered edges. Hush, when no one is around, my dear. You'll find me on my tallest tiptoes.
I think this might be a shorter song.
Yeah,
not really.
Shining just for you. I know they said the end is near, but I'm still on my tallest tiptoes, spinning in my highest heels.
Really quiet, everything's
shining
quiet.
Just for you. And they called off the circus from the disco down, when they sent home the horses and the rodeo clowns. I'm still on that tightrope, I'm still trying everything. Try. I'm still on that trapeze. I'm still trying everything to keep you looking at me.
You just want attention. Okay. Very interesting.
you know, you Taylor Swift fans, you Taylor fans know a lot more than I do. I'm very ignorant when it comes to her songwriting and like meaning behind the songs. I know someone said something, someone commented that there are like three songs from like three different girls' perspectives on the album, and I just don't know what songs they are. I feel like this isn't one of them. And I just wondering, like, is this like how Taylor Swift still is, or is this how she used to be, or is she writing it about someone else? Because I know that she is with someone and has been with someone for a while, so it's just, you know, I feel like she wouldn't be singing about this now. I feel like she's not feeling this way now. Like, this isn't who she is now, but maybe this is who she was at a point. I don't know. Let me know. That was a very chill vibe, very different from the other songs I've listened to so far. And that's definitely toward the top of my list to most favorite songs on the album. Okay, so now we're gonna go into 7. And then we're gonna hit with an ad. You already know. YouTube. I gotta get YouTube $20 million worth of clothing. Psych, I'm not doing that. Get back to work. YouTube thought.
Let's work for a better republic.
All right. Come on.
Learn more at bananarepublic.com.
All right. Okay. 7. Taylor Swift. Yeah. I have nothing else to say. Okay. Let's go.
Please picture me.
Very interesting instrumental. Very different.
In the swing over the creek.
Doesn't even sound like her.
Jumping, but I was high in the sky with Pennsylvania under.
That's where she's from. She's from PA, right?
Still beautiful.
A childhood
days.
Song.
Sweet tea in the summer, cross your heart, won't tell no other. And though I can't recall your face, I still got love for you. Your braids like a pattern, love you to the moon and to Saturn. Pass down like folk songs, the love lasts so.
This is, you know what's weird? I feel like all the chords and notes that I want her to go to, that I'm like, oh, this sounds right, and I kind of just do it in my head before, you know, it gets played, it never goes to that note, which is really interesting, because I feel like if you guys don't know, I am a musician. I do sing, I do play guitar, I play piano. I feel like musicians and probably just normal people who love music, you know, you can kind of tell what note is about to be played. But I feel like with Taylor, I don't know what it is, but like the past 2 songs, I was like doing it and I'm like, this sounds right in my head, and I would do it. But then she goes to a different note. It's strange. I don't know. Not that it's a bad thing. It's definitely not a bad thing. It's just, I feel like I normally am really good at that, but not when it comes to her.
Been meaning to tell you, I think your house is haunted. Your dad is always mad, and that must be why. And I think you should come live with me, and we can be pirates. Then you won't have to cry or hide in the closet. And just like a folk song, our love will be passed on.
Has like a old school vibe to it, at least like the verses do.
I used to scream ferociously anytime I wanted. Sweet tea in the summer, cross my
sweater. We'll move to India forever. Pass on the folk songs. Our love lasts so long.
I have a thought. I'll say it after this song. It's almost over though. Aaron Dessner. Who is Aaron Dessner? I have no idea. Okay, yeah, that's the end of the song. Okay, so this is my thought. I feel like this album is written for Taylor Swift fans. Like, this is really just catering to her fans, like 100%. Because I listened to Lover last year, it came out, I think, right? Yeah, last summer. And like, not gonna lie, I think I enjoyed Lover more than this album so far. And I think that it's because, like, she's literally writing songs for her fans right here. I don't know, that's just a thought. I don't know. Let me know down in the comments if I'm wrong. The song, I don't think that was a bad song. I just don't think it was, I don't think it was that great, honestly. I do like how interesting the instrumental was, though. If I had to give it a plus, I think the instrumental was really interesting. So now we're going to move into August by Taylor Swift. If you guys are still watching this, I am like, wow, you guys are literally the best. What, this is about to be the sixth track in. And it's already been like, what, 28 minutes, something like that? I don't know. Anyway, let's get this started. I'm gonna make this video so long, dude. I'm just talking way too much. I like the font, man.
Salt air.
I already off the bat, this, I have a feeling this is probably gonna be my favorite song so far. I could just, I don't know, something about it.
Salt air and the rust on your door. I never needed anything more. Or whispers of are you sure? Never have I ever before. But I can see us lost in the memory. August slipped away into a moment in time. Cause it was never mine. And I can see us twisted in bed sheets. August slipped away like a bottle of wine. Cause you were never mine. You're back beneath the sun. Wishing I could write my name.
I thought it was gonna be a different vibe, not gonna lie. It's chill though.
When you're back at school.
I feel like you can kind of drive around and just listen to all these songs, like at night.
But I can see us lost in the memory. August slipped away into a moment in time. Cause it was never mine. And I can see us twisted in bedsheets. August slipped away like a bottle of wine. Cause you were never mine.
I love this instrumental right here.
Back when we were still changing for the better.
Yeah.
Wanting was enough. For me, it was enough. To live for the hope of it all. Cancel plans just in case you call. And say, meet me behind the mall. So much for summer love. Saying us cause you weren't.
Really good bridge.
But I can see us lost in the memory. August slipped away into a moment in time. Cause it was never mine. And I can see us twisted in bed sheets. August slipped away like a bottle of wine. Cause you were never mine. Cause you were never mine.
There's so much space in like her instrumentals, like
do you remember
and then canceled my plans just in case you'd call. Dang. That's like, to me, like, that sounds like, you know, like you're in your childhood phase. And I think this is a blast from the past type of a song. Like, remember, like, this time. Yeah, I feel like, because I remember back in high school, you know, I had an ex who did that, you know, who did things like that. And that's just like a really just like childhood mindset. But like in high school, when you're growing up and you just really, really like a person, sometimes you get blinded, especially when you're that young and you do stupid things like that. That's funny. Back when I was living for the hope of it all. That's it. Okay. So right off the bat, I was like, this is probably gonna be my favorite song on the album. And I think it probably is. I'd put it up there with Cardigan. It gave me a completely different vibe than what I was expecting. But not in a bad way. I just was expecting something different. I think the highlights of the song was definitely that breakdown at the very end of the song, and also the bridge. It was just really kind of like raw. It was like she was singing like sort of offbeat, and or singing where you didn't expect her to sing, and she just did a really good job with it. And yeah, I think it was a good song, not gonna lie. Also, another thought, I feel like she leaves a lot of space in her instrumentals or just in the music in general. Like, it feels like, so this album at least just feels like really airy, and there's so many like little things going on in the background that you don't really notice and you can't really put your finger on it. But it just creates like a whole atmosphere. It's really airy and light, and there's just a lot of room. So like if I really wanted to, if I was feeling myself literally throughout this whole song, whenever there was like a break of an instrumental, I could literally just be singing in that instrumental. And yeah, she could do that too, you know, at any single point, because there's just so much room for it. Now, I talked for way too long there. I apologize, but we're going to do, this is me trying. And then I'm going to switch my battery out because, yeah, I don't want it to die. Hopefully it doesn't die mid-song. I'll be pissed. Stadia, okay, YouTube, just keep hitting me with the ads. Keep doing it. I wonder if this was all filmed in PA. Would make sense. Some really like organ right there.
Maybe I violins come in. How do they play? I freaking don't know. So beautiful.
They told me all of my cages were mental, so I got wasted like all my potential. Mm. And my words shoot to kill when I'm mad. I have a lot of regrets about that. I was so ahead of the curve. The curve became a sphere. Fell behind all my classmates and I ended up here. Pouring out my heart to a stranger. But I didn't pour the whiskey. I just wanted you to know that this is me trying. I just wanted you to know that this is me trying.
What I'm saying, it's so airy, there's so much space everywhere. Woo! I love, oh, woo! That right there, that does it for me right there, man. Oh my gosh, I never thought I would do that to a Taylor Swift song, by the way. That's how you know I'm not a hater, guys, okay? If you're still watching, that's crazy, but anyway.
It's hard to be anywhere these days when all I want is you. You're a flashback and a film reel on the one screen in my town. And I just wanted you.
Okay, Taylor. Okay, Taylor. There's, oh, that's a trend too going on with this album. Every single song I think I've heard does, like, you know, just a fade out, you know, just a long fade out. Anyway, gonna change the battery real quick, doing a cut. I mean, you guys aren't gonna see me changing the battery, but okay, let's do it. Okay, and we're back. Okay, now, oh wait. Let me give my thoughts on the song before I forget. This is me trying, Taylor Swift. This is my favorite song on the album by far. As you guys can tell from my reaction, I never thought I'd freak out like that over a Taylor Swift song. But yeah, that instrumental and then going into like the bridge, that was incredible, honestly. I'm really impressed. That was a good song. Very freaking good song. Now we're gonna go straight into Illicit Affairs. And I didn't get an ad. Thank you, YouTube. There's so much air everywhere, so much room.
Make sure nobody sees you leave. Put over your head, keep your eyes down. Tell your friends you're out for a run. You'll be flushed when you return. Take the road less traveled by. Tell yourself you can always stop. What started in beautiful rooms ends with meetings in parking lots. And that's the thing about illicit affairs and clandestine meetings and longing stares. It's born from just one single glance, but it dies and it dies and it dies a million little times. Leave the perfume on the shelf that you picked out just for him, so you leave no trace.
I love whatever that is, like that sample. It's just like a voice. It's just her voice, but it's like, I don't know what they did to it. It just sounds really cool whenever it hits.
Out just for him.
That sounds awesome.
So
I love
you leave
that.
No trace behind, like you don't even exist.
take the words for what they are. A dwindling mercurial high, a drug that only worked the first few hundred times. And that's the thing about illicit affairs and clandestine meetings and stolen stares. They show their truth one single time, but they lie and they lie and they lie a million little times.
Man.
And you wanna scream, don't call me kid, don't call me baby. Look at this godforsaken mess that you made me. You showed me colors you know I can't see with anyone else. Don't call me kid, don't call me baby. Look at this idiotic fool that you made me. You taught me a secret language I can't speak with anyone else. And you know damn well, for you I would ruin myself a million little times.
Wow. There was literally so much emotion coming through that song. So much emotion. Just like anger. Like literally just anger coming through. Wow. Very, very interesting. I like that one a lot. It was very emotional. Like I said, I don't know, man. That's written very well once again. Not going to find a Taylor Swift song that's not written well. So now gonna go into Invisible String, and I'm gonna hit with an ad. It's okay though. It's okay. I'll live, I think, hopefully. Okay, this sounds a little happier. Not exactly, but
green was the color of the grass where I used to read at Centennial Park. I used to think I would meet somebody. Color of your shirt when you were 16 at the yogurt shop. You used to work at to make a little money.
That makes sense.
Time, play is time. Give me no compasses, give me no signs. Were there clues I didn't see? And isn't it just so pretty to think?
Interesting idea
that
for a song.
That was the plot of the song in the cab on your first trip to LA. You ate at my favorite spot for dinner. Bold was the waitress on our three-year trip, getting lunch down by the lakes. She said I looked like an American singer. Time, mystical time, cutting me open then healing me fine. With a clue
she's done this a lot, is like with the choruses. She did in the last song too. It's like, it's literally the chorus, like the melody is the same, it's the chorus, it's just changing certain words or certain phrases. So like time, mystical time, I forget what it said in the first one. It didn't say mystical, it didn't say cutting me open then healing me fine. It did not say that. It said something about where were there signs, where, and then this was the same. Were there clues I didn't see? That was the same. But it's, I like when artists do that, like, not gonna lie.
See. Isn't it just so pretty to think all along there were some invisible string tying you to me?
I don't know what it is about the font. I'm really into fonts, guys. And I like these fonts.
Out of all the wrong ones, right into that dive bar.
boys who broke my heart. Now I send their babies presents. Gold was the color of the leaves when I showed you around Centennial Park. Hell was the journey, but it brought me heaven.
Yeah.
Time, wondrous time, give me the blues and then purple pink sky. And it's cool. So pretty to think all along there was some invisible string tying you to me.
Ooh. I love the way the song's written. I really do. Just like every song, there's this long outro that slowly fades away. Very interesting choice to do for every single song, but it is pretty, so I understand it. I think like that's what she was going for. Sorry, that was just an abrupt just ending, because it's like really pretty instrumental, it's really airy, and then they just, you know, let it ride out and then just fade into nothing. Yeah, I like the song. I like the way that it was written. And I love, like, it's just so pretty to think. Because, like, at first I was like, pretty to think. Like, that's something, like, that, you know, females say that, not males. Males do not say, oh, it's so pretty to think about it like that. But I understand the perspective and thinking that way. Like, it's so pretty to think about, you know, how we even met and how, like, all these things in our lives just kind of led us to each other. I like that. I do. It's pretty to think. Okay. That was really corny. Now let's go to Mad Women by Taylor Swift.
I browsed 8 and sites for divorce.
Getting hit. Apple ad. Okay. Okay, I'm not trying to watch it. I'm not trying to hear it, okay? Now you're just going to hear my voice instead of the ad. It's probably worse for you guys, but better for me. All right. Really complex guitar lick going on.
What did you think I'd say to that? Does a scorpion sting when fighting back? They strike to kill, and you know I will. You know I will.
That's what this song called. Mad Woman.
What do you sing on your drive home? Do you see my face in the neighbor's lawn? Does she smile? What does she mouth? Fuck you forever.
Taylor!
Every time you call me crazy, I get more crazy. What about that? And when you say I seem angry, I get more angry. And there's nothing like a mad woman. What a shame she went mad. No one likes a mad woman. You made her like that. And you poke that bear till her claws come out, and you find something to wrap your noose around. And there's nothing like a man, woman.
Dang. I love that. It's like, bro, like, this girl crazy, but like, dude, you made her like that. Like, all the crap that you put her through, like, that's why she's like that right now.
Now I breathe flames each time I talk. My cannon's all firing at your yacht. They say, move on, but you know I won't.
Oh, dude, you hear, like, the slight electric guitar? I'm waiting for it to just go crazy, but it's definitely not going to go crazy. But,
You know, I'm excited to see where the song leads.
And women like hunting witches too, doing your dirtiest work for you. It's obvious that wanting me dead has really brought you two together. Every time you call me crazy, you're getting more crazy. What about that? And when you say I seem angry, you're getting more angry. And there's nothing like a mad woman. What a shame she went mad. No one likes a mad woman.
I love the atmosphere at the back. Like, it's just so nice. Always know. Desner, once again, coming in clutch. All right. Now we're going to move. Wait, never mind. Let me get my thoughts. Like I said, I mean, I really loved the atmosphere of the song. I love the emotions behind it. And I like the just the writing. The writing's always really good. I'm going to say it. I've said it too many times. You know, the writing's just always going to be good with Taylor Swift. No lie. It's a good song. Good song. Not my favorite, but definitely not my least favorite. I think it's like, it's toward like the upper hand of my, the upper end of my favorite song. So now we're going to go right into Epiphany. I had Epiphany. I was repeating history. Never did to me. Yeah. I had an epiphany. Was a smile on my enemies. You guys know that song NF featuring or futuristic featuring NF? You guys probably don't know this because y'all are Swifties. Okay. You know, I'm by myself here. I got to have a little bit of fun, okay? Now we're going to get into Epiphany. Let's go. All these songs are, like, pretty long, too. Nice pad going on. I like the font. What can I say? Really heavy.
Keep your helmet, keep your life, son. Just a flesh.
Rub some dirt on it, bro.
Here's your rifle. Crawling off the beaches now. Someone's mother.
plastic now.
I really like that melody.
Doc, I think she's crashing out. And some things you just can't speak about.
I feel like that was a quick 4 minutes that just went by. I don't know. This is about to be a long freaking video. If you guys are still watching this, that's crazy. Because it's not like Lover or a lot of just, not just Lover, but just any typical album that you listen to or just most albums. It's like, it's really airy, really light. There's a lot of empty space and a lot of moments where there's really not much going on. Like there's a lot of stuff going on, like the background, like the atmospheres and everything. But it's like nothing is like crazy that's happening. So for me, it's actually really hard to react to it. Because yeah, it's just very difficult. So if you're here, you know, I applaud you, and you guys are real Swifties, or you guys just really like me, you know, I don't know, but we're gonna go right into Betty. Okay, this one seems like a little more poppin', has 9 million listens or watches.
Life is filled
and we're getting hit with another ad. I'm getting pissed off, okay? We're gonna skip these ads, okay? Thank you, YouTube, for giving me the skip. I'm glad. Nice little harmonica. I used to want to play one so bad.
Betty, I won't make assumptions about why you switched your homeroom, but I think it's because of me.
Okay, so I feel like this is another song from another chick's perspective.
I was riding on my skateboard when I passed your house. It's like I couldn't breathe.
Oh, love triangle thing.
You heard the rumors from Inez. You can't believe a word she says most times, but this time it was true. The worst thing that I ever did was what I did to you. But if I just showed up at your party, would you have me? Would you want me? Would you tell me to go fuck myself? Or lead me to the garden? In the garden,
Taylor.
Would you trust me if I told you?
Who
it was
are
just
you?
A summer thing. I'm only 17. I don't know anything, but I know I miss you.
She stole her girl.
I know where it all went wrong. Your favorite
song was playing from the far side of the gym. I was nowhere to be found. I hate the crowds, you know that. Plus I saw you dance with him. You heard the rumors from Ines. You can't believe a word she says most times, but this time it was true. The worst thing that I ever did was what I did to you. But if I just showed up at your party, would you have me? Would you want me? Would you tell me to go fuck myself? Or lead me
so
to
hard
the
to
garden?
Hear,
in the garden, would you trust me if I told you it was just a summer thing? I'm only 17, I don't know anything, but I know I miss you.
Dang. Friendship is really just broken. So sad.
I was walking home on broken cobblestones, just thinking of you when she pulled up like a figment of my worst intentions. She said, James, get in, let's drive. Those days turned into nights, slept next to her, but I dreamt of you all summer long. Doorstep, and I planned it out for weeks now, but it's finally sinking in. Betty, right now is the last time I can dream about.
This is definitely a Swiftie song for sure. Again.
The only thing I wanna do is make it up to you.
Oh, how nice.
So I showed up at your party.
Aw.
Yeah, I showed up at your party.
Very kind.
Yeah, I showed up at your party.
Nice key change. Alright, definitely a Swiftie song, 100%. And because of that, I feel like it's not really a song I really particularly enjoyed too much. It just sounds like a Little Behind Ked song, honestly, not even gonna lie, but we're gonna go right into peace. yeah, let's get this started. I'm loving all the scenery in these videos. I wish they weren't just loops, but that's okay. It's fine, I guess. That's really cool. That's really, really cool, dude.
A coming of age has come and gone. Suddenly this summer it's clear. I never had the courage of my convictions, as long as danger is near. And it's just around the corner, darling, cause it lives in me.
The instrumental's so cool.
No,
dude.
I could never give you peace.
Mm-hmm. a storm's a brewing.
But I'm a fire and I'll keep your brittle heart warm. If you cascade ocean wave blues come, all these people think love's for show, but I would die for your secret. The devil's in the details, but you got a friend in me. Would it be enough if I could never give you peace? Your integrity makes me seem small. You paint dreamscapes on the wall. I talk shit with my friends. It's like I'm wasting your honor.
So, yeah, it just seems like she's just contemplating right now, and it's a constant struggle in her head. She's like, I know, like she's kind of like looking at herself, like just down on herself, like she's seeing like all these problems, like she's a bad person or whatever, and then she sees her significant other as this amazing person who's really, really kind, and you know, she's talking about like gossiping with her friends and everything like that. It's like, she thinks in her head, like, yeah, my dude, my man's not going to approve of this. And he'll probably think of me in a different way if he knew me in this light. But that's like stuff all goes on in your head. You know, these are things that happen in relationships, or when you're just talking to someone, you're like, if they knew this thing about me, they might not feel the same way. Yeah.
And you know that I swing with you for the fences, sit with you in the trenches, give you my wild, give you a child, give you the silence that only comes when two people understand each other. Family that I chose, now that I see your brother as my brother. Is it enough? But there's robbers to the east, clowns to the west. I'd give you my sunshine, give you my best, but the rain is always gonna come if you're standing with me. But I'm a fire and I'll keep your brittle heart warm. If you cascade ocean wave blues come, all these people think love's for show, but I would die for your secret. The devil's in the details, but you got a friend in me. Would it be enough if I could never give you peace? Would it be enough if I could never give you peace? Would it be enough if I could never give you peace?
Dang, man. Dang. The struggle internally, what's just going on. I really, she wrote that just really, really well, man. It's like she loves the person and she knows that he loves her as well, but like I was saying before, it's like letting that person in or giving yourself completely to that person is difficult. She's basically just saying, like, I have all these problems, and no matter what season we're in, there's always going to be like all these struggles, and when I give myself fully to you, when I come into your life, there's going to be so many problems that you didn't have to deal with before. I love that. And also what's nice is there's no resolution. She's just leaving it as that thought, those emotions going on in her head. And that's the song. And a lot of people do feel like that sometimes going into relationships or even friendships. So yeah, I like that. Now we're moving into Hoax. Once again, YouTube hitting me with these ads, as you guys can see. This is a long freaking video, man. This might be the longest video I've ever recorded. Very interesting, to say the least. Yeah, if you guys are still here, y'all are some real ones, or you're just Swifties, or you guys really like me. I don't know, man. I don't know. But we're moving on to Hoax. It's just Hoax and then the Lakes. And then I'm done. So two more songs. Let's go. Two more songs. Let's get through this. 3 minutes, 41 seconds. Hoax.
My only one.
This is gorgeous, by the way.
My smoking gun.
I need to go here.
My eclipsed sun. This has broken me down. My twisted knife. My sleepless night. My windless fight. This has frozen my ground. Stood on the cliffside screaming, give me a reason.
It's talking to God.
Your faithless love's the only hoax I believe in. Don't want no other shade of blue but you. No other sadness in the world would do. My best laid plan, your sleight of hand, my barren land. I am ash from your fire.
Yours tired
on the cliffside screaming, give me a reason. Your faithless love's the only hoax I believe in. Don't want no other shade of blue but you. No other sadness in the world would do. You know I left a part of me back in New York. You knew the hero died, so what's the movie for? You knew it still hurts underneath my scars from when they pulled me apart. You knew the password, so I let you in the door. You knew you won, so what's the point of keeping score? You knew it still hurts underneath my scars from when they pulled me apart. But what you did was just as dark. Just as hard as when they pulled me apart. My only one, my kingdom come undone. My broken drum, you have beaten my heart. Don't want no other shade of blue but you. No other sadness in the world would do.
I think it's just gonna, this is really pretty though. Love the piano, the violin. Trying to think of what she was like going for that song. To me it just sounded like I don't know, man. I really don't know. It's like, well, someone left her and she was still believing for that love to come through, and you know, but I don't know. I feel like it might be like leading up into her talking about the person she has now, or I don't know. I don't know. I have no idea, dude. This could just be like just flashbacks and going back in time to points in her life. But now we made it to the end of the album. Taylor Swift, The Lakes. We're not getting hit with an ad, so that's phenomenal. All right, if you guys made it to the end of the video, y'all are amazing. Thank you guys so much. Like the video, comment, subscribe, because if you're here, you guys obviously like me. So, or you guys hate me, or you guys just love Taylor Swift that much that you guys are still here. But either way, subscribe, like, and comment. 3 minutes and 30 seconds, The Lakes. I feel like this might be a happy ending to the album. I'm really hoping it's a happy song. Let's add out of here. Instrumentals are all so interesting in this album.
Is it romantic how all my elegies eulogize me? I'm not cut out for all these cynical clones, these hunters with cell phones. Take me to the lakes where all the poets went to die. I don't belong, and my beloved neither do you. Those Windermere peaks look like a perfect place to cry. I'm setting off, but not without my muse.
Oh God.
What should be over, but rode under my skin. In heart-stopping waves of hurt, I've come too far to watch some name-dropping sleaze tell me what are my words worth. Take me to the lakes where all the poets went to die. I don't belong, and my beloved neither do you. Those Windermere peaks look like a perfect place to cry. I'm setting off, but not without my muse. I want auroras and sapros. I want to watch wisteria grow right over my bare feet, 'cause I haven't moved in. I want you right here. A red rose grew up out of ice frozen ground with no one around to tweet it. I
love that line right there.
Cliffside pools with my calamitous love and insurmountable grief. Take me to the lakes where all the poets went to die. I don't belong. My beloved, neither do you. Those Windermere peaks look like a perfect place to cry. I'm setting off, but not without my muse. No, not without you.
I think that's a good way to end the album. I could be wrong, but to me it kind of sounded like essentially that she just went through all this stuff, and it's depicted throughout the album, all this stuff where she was heartbroken and maybe just like confused, and she felt like she was a bad person and that her significant other, the person that she really was into, was just more, a lot cleaner than she was, and she has this, all this dirt, but at the end of the day she loves that person loves her, and even though she has all this dirt on her and an ice cold heart, she said like a rose grew up out of the ice. It's like, it's not even supposed to do that, but for some reason it did. She's still going. Beauty came from the ashes. And yeah. Now she can't go without this person, or not that she can't go, but that she wants to go on life or through life with this person. But anyway, I don't know. I'm not a Swiftie, you know. I know like she references other songs and does all this crazy stuff with her songwriting, so I don't know all the intricacies to her writing at all. I'm just going completely surface level, first listen.
I'm sure if I listened to it more, I'd get more stuff out of the songs, but you know, this is first listen. And yeah, I think the album was catered to Taylor Swift fans for sure. For me, it was not that it was hard to listen to. It was very easy to listen to because of how like airy and light and really just pretty and beautiful the instrumentals were, along with the melody lines, just very nice. Everything was very cohesive. But in terms of like reacting to it, it's hard to give like crazy reactions or good reactions and give a lot of my thoughts when there's all this space in the songs and there's not like too much crazy stuff going on, so it's hard to react to it. So I hope you guys understand where I'm coming from. But you know, it's not that I didn't enjoy the album. I think I did enjoy listening to it. But I do like Lover more than this one. But I do understand this one's appeal. I think this is, like I said, it's just catered more toward Taylor Swift fans. And it's like a really just, the whole album is just like a deep cut. There's no like, oh, this is the single that comes out from the album. It's just like everything's a deep cut. And, you know, I think that's great. And her songwriting is on point once again. Always just phenomenal songwriting, especially with that, this last song. She just always does a great job with songwriting. So, yeah, as you guys can tell, I'm not a freaking Taylor Swift hater. I'm just not much of a fan. But like I said, I'll give praise where praise is due or props. But yeah, overall probably give the album like a, from my perspective, 1 out of 10, 10 being the best. I'd probably give it like a 5. If I'm just being honest. Like I said, there was no like, there was one song, I forget what it was called, that I was like, where I was like, oh, that's actually really incredible. But that was the only time I ever felt like that. So yeah, I'd give the whole album just a 5. Not that it's bad, it's just not for me. But I understand it can appeal to a lot of people. So if you guys did enjoy this reaction, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.